Yurozaya meets up with this unexpected 90-day fiancé couple to celebrate birthday. Hello lovely viewers, and welcome back to Vogue America new episode with Lucy. Celebrated her 30th birthday in Mexico with popular 90-day fiancé franchise cast members Armanda Rubio and Kenny Niedermeyer. Yara was first featured in 90 Day Fiancé Season 8 alongside her American partner, Jovi Dufresne. Despite facing communication problems, including Jovi's interest in strip clubs, the couple got married in Las Vegas after Yara unexpectedly became pregnant. A few years after their wedding, Yara and Jovi underwent therapy on 90 Day, The Last Resort, which helped strengthen their marriage. Recently celebrated her 30th birthday and surprised fans by hanging out with the iconic 90 Day Fiancé franchise duo Kenny and Armando. She partied with them at a private event in Polanco, Mexico City. Kenny and Armando posted videos of Yara on their Instagram story, wishing her the best. The Mexican reality star shared a clip of Yara dancing, titled, "Happy 30th Yara, Yes We Can Party." Armando also shared another clip featuring him and Kenny enjoying fancy-looking beverages with the Ukrainian native and her husband, Jovi. Armando and Kenny weren't the only 90 Day Fiancé stars who congratulated Yara on her birthday. Other co-stars, such as Sumit Singh, Jenny Slaton, Annie Suwan, Chantal Everett, David Taborowski, Kim Menzies, and many others shared their best wishes on her Instagram post. The greetings that stood out came from Yara's mother-in-law, Winnie Mart. She wrote, "Happy birthday again, Yara. Hope it was a great one." Yara thanked her mother-in-law and sent her a red heart emoji. Her reply made a fan comment, "This relationship is everything." At first, it seemed like Yara would be a gold digger like other 90 Day Fiancé stars such as Larissa Lima and Anfisa Nava. However, Yara proved everyone wrong, showing her devotion to family and friends. Despite Jovi's red flags like his obsession with strip clubs and drinking habits, Yara fought for their relationship and never gave up on him. "It's heartwarming to see people showering Yara with compliments. She truly deserves the love for being an exceptional mother, an amazing wife, and a lovely daughter." Jovi took Yara to Mexico City to celebrate her birthday, where they met Armando and Kenny, who recently relocated there after much debate in 90 Day Fiancé: The Other Way Season 5. Despite initial disagreements, Armando and Kenny left their La Mission house and settled in Mexico City with their daughter Hannah. Yara and Jovi also moved recently and chose Miami, Florida, as their new home. Hopefully, the 90 Day Fiancé cast members had a great time together, sharing stories about their new cities. The 90 Day Fiancé fans divided over Lauren Brevarnik's selfishness. It seems that 90 Day Fiancé fans are divided over Lauren Brevarnik's selfishness. This comes from her getting a mommy makeover done. During 90 Day Fiancé, Happily Ever After, fans have seen Lauren go through the recovery of her procedure. However, fans have a lot of mixed opinions on what she should have done regarding the surgery. Keep reading to find out more about this. Lauren Brevarnik gets surgery. Lauren Brevarnik was seen getting surgery done on the show. This was a mommy makeover. Lauren did not feel confident in her body and wanted to get rid of the extra fat in places. What happened was they took the fat from places she did not want it and moved it to places like her butt. So nothing artificial was injected into her and she says it was all natural. The surgery took 7 hours and her husband Alexei was stressing the entire time. Since her surgery, she cannot lift her children. Lauren has 3 children under 3 years old. She was very selfish and naive. "It's amazing to me that people don't understand how intense plastic surgery is on the body. Everyone suffered for her vanity. All the work of the pregnancies were on her. Alex can take the reins for a few weeks without the world falling apart. Unpopular opinion, good for her. I think doing it younger is a lot better than waiting to get older and having more potential health risks. It was a family decision between her and her husband." It seems that there are a lot of different opinions when it comes to Lauren getting her surgery done. While some feel that she should do what makes her feel best, others feel that she should have waited for her kids to be older. Maybe this is also due to Lauren saying she may give in and have another child and get the surgery redone. This means she would have to go through this all over again. What do you think about her getting the surgery done? What side are you on? Sound off in the comments below. Angela Deem, Michael Ailsami. Angela Deem uncovers shocking information about Michael Ailsami on 90 Day Fiancé, Happily Ever After. After searching through his cell phone, she is convinced he is scamming her for a ticket to the United States. Angela Deem is in Nigeria with Michael Ailsami, waiting for him to get his spousal visa. However, she has been catching him in lies after lies. She finds out that he was the one who changed his interview from Nigeria to the Ivory Coast. So now she wants to find out what other lies her husband is hiding. The 90 Day Fiancé. Happily Ever After cast member asks him to give her his phone. He does, and she searches through it. She then finds out that he is part of a group that has been sending money to someone. He explains to her that it is like a piggy bank. It is where he keeps money aside for rainy days. Angela wants to know more about this piggy bank. So, Michael explains that it is common in his country to give someone money to keep it for emergencies. He adds that it is like a savings account. The TLC celeb feels that Michael Alasami is keeping this money aside so that when he comes to America, he has money in case she kicks him out. However, he explains that the money can't be used there. Angela uncovers Michael's secret group chat. Angela continues to search and then finds out that Michael is the admin for a group chat called Paradise Men. He explains to her that it is a group for men who are on the same visa journey as he is. The 90 Day Fiancé. Happily Ever After castmate feels the group is for people scamming women from America. She believes that her husband knows when the spousal visa is coming. She feels he wants her to go home so he can get his opportunity to go to the US without her. Angela feels that there has been some scamming going on. She believes it makes sense because Michael has been secretly depositing money into a piggy bank account. She wants to contact an immigration lawyer, and if the lawyer advises her to get out, she's out. Angela Deem takes Michael Alasami's phone back to her hotel. The TLC star decides to keep digging. She discovers that her husband is the administrator of a group chat that helps Nigerian men meet old American women to get a green card. She even finds out that he charges these men for his help. The 90 Day Fiancé. Happily Ever After celeb also finds screenshots of online searches on how life insurance works in America. Angela worries that Michael will try to get rid of her and get the money from the insurance company. She even discovers that he gave some random person her tax return information. However, she isn't going to let him get away with using her.